Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our prophecy news update for Wednesday night. Normally, we do our wine press this time of the night, but tonight we're having a building update for our church. But I did want to take the opportunity to bring you some prophetic news and things going on because it's rapidly moving toward the coming of Jesus Christ. And praise God. Look, it may scare you, some of the changes that are happening in our world, but bear in mind, for there to be a one world government, there can't be a superpower. Everybody has to be willing to come and submit together, which means everybody's got to be in the same boat. And of course, we know that the cataclysmic event that's going to pull the world together to a one world government is not COVID-19. It's going to be the rapture of the church when millions go missing in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye. It's going to change the face, not just of the United States. It's going to change the face of the world. Think about it. All those in the eugenics program and all those that are pushing for population control, believing that we're in a mess because we're breeding too fast and there's too many people, they're going to get their wish. When all of us are gone, population is going to decrease. But it's going to bring a lot of other problems too, because the believers and the children won't be here anymore. And that's going to be the cataclysmic event. But let's walk through some of the dry runs that are happening right now that are going to change the face of America. Okay? So four news articles tonight we want to bring up. And the first one is this. Los Angeles, California. Help us, God. Just when you say California, you go, oh, my God, what next? Right? Los Angeles, California school chief says the kids must have the coronavirus vaccine to return to school. Now, and they're trying to put the coronavirus in the same arena as measles, mumps, smallpox, tuberculosis. Understand, they're taking a cold virus, and they're trying to put a cold virus in the same category as a disease. Is anybody missing this other than just me? Not just that, a virus with a 98% cure rate, okay? And they're trying to make it where our children can't, you know, there's got to be more to this vaccination than just giving you a shot to stop a cold or a flu bug. There's something else going on, okay? And if you follow back through our news articles since this began, there's many, many things happening with this RNA-based vaccine. And many have had to take it because of their jobs. And we pray for their safety and for their health, okay? But just watch what happens, all right? The next article that we're bringing up says, big tech censorship in U.S. News and World Report. And a Jewish rabbi calls this the part of war of Gog and Magog. Now, I'm not sure how the rabbi connects Russia and Gog Magog. I'm not sure how he connects that. But this I know. Censorship in the overtaking of any government, in the overthrowing of any people. The first thing you do in any military move is you cut off communication. Communication and supplies. Those things have to go away. Because we, the American people, can't trust the news anymore. I mean, honest to God, we don't know who's telling the truth and who isn't telling the truth. There's just no way of knowing anymore. And so those that we think do tell the truth, they're now being censored off of the very telephone apps that we've learned to depend on. We've eliminated our, think about it, we lost free television, went to cable television, now everybody's doing satellite television, and the apps have reduced down, and now big media has been exposed as being owned by liberal left-wingers that are anti-God and anti-church, and so where's the truth? So we're walking around in the blind going, what's happening next? Just the other night, right here in our area, there was several loud airplane bursts for several hours, and several people were very, very concerned. We drove out to the airport to see what was going on, and it was just an airplane doing some engine test, and they were working on the jet engines on this airplane, But with the ceiling low and the air cold and all this talk of the National Guard being deployed and all of this going on, there were people lined up all around the airport with cameras and phones and talking, going, what's going on? What's going on? Fear, fear, fear. Listen, child of God, it doesn't matter what they do. Your government is a government beyond this world. Your economy is an economy beyond this world. You are going to be taken care of by your king. Don't worry. Don't be afraid. Instead, use this opportunity. This is a great time when you see people worried to go, yeah, you know, the Bible talked about these things coming. Isn't it funny that these things were prophesied thousands of years ago that they were going to happen? Doesn't that open up a door and a window of conversation that you can have with people that before, hey, they were just cruising along in life. Everything was fine and blissful. Nothing new to them, right? Now, every day, we've got new surprises and new things happening. How about this next article? China plans further crackdown on Hong Kong after mass arrest. And I think this is interesting because if you go back a few months ago, the one thing you discover very quickly is that China overthrew Hong Kong. Hong Kong was its own independent country. Now they've been annexed into China, and it happened without firing a bullet. They stepped in, they took them over, following the same protocol and plan that they're trying to use to conquer the world. Listen, the Chinese government setup is all about one world rule, one currency, controlling the masses by facial recognition and by social credit scores. And we're seeing more of that happen right here. They're cracking down. Watch now. The cracking down on the Democrats being arrested in China, they're comparing that to the Tiananmen Square uprising that happened. All it is people going, no, we have a right to vote. People trying to stand up for basic freedoms. And if you're watching the United States right now, our basic freedoms are being removed. We're losing them. And we're taking it silently. We're just kind of letting it happen. I'm not sure how to feel about this as an American. As a Christian, as a pastor, I'm going to do my part to fight it. But at the same time, I know for Christ to come back, these things have to happen. We just happen to live in the worst of times and the best of times. And more than ever, we need to pray. And we need to stand together and love one another. Love one another. Doesn't matter what party you're part of. You're all a child of God. And to be honest with you, the Republican Party has been just as disappointing as the Democratic Party. But the only party that hasn't disappointed anybody is Jesus Christ. His word is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He doesn't change. Can you say amen? Amen. Okay? So, watching world news. It's happening. The stage is being set for the return of Jesus Christ and the rule of the Antichrist. Wow. We might get to see it happen. Amen. And the last article I want to bring up. To land up on some good news. In this picture that we have, this is Deshaun Watson being baptized in the River Jordan. Now, if you've ever been to Israel, you know there are two places they like to baptize you in water. One is a garden up in the northern part of the river coming right off the Sea of Galilee. And it's cold. I mean cold, cold, cold water. But it's not the place where Jesus was baptized or the place where the children of Israel crossed over from Jordan into the promised land. This lower half of the river has been plagued for years. In fact, the first time I went, we were on a narrow, narrow gravel road going down to the river, which isn't very wide, maybe 20, 25 feet across. And we're going down, we notice that we're running beside two very, very stiff wired fences, and every 5 or 6 feet it's got a sign on it that says, danger, mines, okay? So honestly, if you step on the other side of that fence, you might get blown to smithereens, okay? And for the first time, listen, this is what's amazing. And you've got to see how this works into prophecy, okay? Because this is a great place for a military might to cross over into Israel. But they couldn't because all these mines have been left there for dozens of years now, and you could barely get a bus down through there or a small Jeep. They have cleared out over 6,000 mines around the Jordan River Valley here now. And it you can cross over it with an amphibious vehicle. You don't have to have a bridge to get over the Jordan River in this place. Okay? So even the landscape is changing in the Holy Land as people are getting ready for the coming of Messiah. Now let's talk about something a minute. Okay? Moms, dads, grandparents, listen to me. This has stolen the minds of your children. Listen to me well. Jewish tradition from the beginning of time forward, Hebrew, Jewish, and even in my childhood. Do you remember the days of your mom and your dad sitting with you every night and telling you a Bible story? Having you ask questions? Remember the Bible salesman that used to come by the house selling the Bible story books? I want you to think about it a minute. Those stories are lost among our children now. They're lost. Sunday schools have died in churches, not because churches didn't see the value in them, but because people wouldn't come. But the worst part about it is we're facing the days we're facing right now with children that don't know the basic stories of the Bible. They know more about fictional characters. They know more about movie stars than celebrities. Anything that comes up on Facebook, on TikTok, on all these social media platforms, these little stories and all this stuff they're following, this fantasy that's not real, that's made up to collect and gather the mind of your child. Moms, dads, please hear me. Grandparents, please hear me. It's time we get back around the family table. It's time we sit around the couch in the living room with our kids. It's time before they go to bed at night that you get out your Bible and you read them a Bible story. You share with them some of the stories of how faithful God is, because they're going to need it. They're going to need to know that even though the world's changing, God does not. They're going to need to know that even though the world's falling apart, God does not. And it's our responsibility to raise them up in the way they should go. We certainly can't depend on the schools to do it. And we certainly can't depend on social media to do it. Mom and dad, grandparents, this is our responsibility. And you know, several Sundays ago, I put a challenge out to our church. Every time they sit down at a meal, to begin to share testimonies of the goodness of God. Well, every Tuesday at our pastor's breakfast, we sit and I throw out a subject. Tell me a miracle that God did in the area of health or finance or while you were in travel. And it never fails every week that everybody at the table has stories of how good and faithful God has been. But here's what's starting to happen now. Others sitting there in the restaurant are listening to the stories that the men and women of God are sharing. In fact, a couple of weeks ago, we had a gentleman come over to the table and his eyes were watered up and he said, "You don't know how much it meant for me to hear the stories of how good God has been to you." And he shared a testimony with us and we were encouraged. Isn't that amazing? So upcoming, very soon, we have our studio area built and we're going to begin asking you, come share a testimony of the faithfulness of God. We're going to record it. We're going to put it out on the internet and try to make it go viral. We're going to try to make Jesus famous and let the faithfulness of God stand true. And right here in our own Journey Church family, we have an author. Now, is she famous? I think she is. She's famous to me. Her name is Frances Croner. And Miss Frances has written children's books, okay, telling a beautiful story of Jesus Christ. And she wrote this book, gave me a copy of it a while back, Donita, the donkey that carried Jesus. The story of that donkey's life. And it is a beautiful, beautiful story of God's faithfulness. This book is available through our Journey Church bookstore. You can call in, approach us online, or if you're here with us, come by, stop by our little bookstore and pick a copy of this. Read this and share it with your children. Great opportunity for your kids to know more about our loving Savior who is coming soon. Amen? Let me have a word of prayer with you before we go for tonight. Let me pray a blessing over you and your family. Father, thank you for those that are listening and following. Lord, as long as our freedom is allowed, we're going to use it. As long as the internet's allowed for us to carry the good news of Jesus on, we're going to do it. As long as that door is open, we're going to walk through it. But Father, tonight I pray that parents and grandparents begin feeling the responsibility, Lord, of teaching our children about the love and the faithfulness of a kind and tender God. And Lord, I pray that they feel that burden, that they pick it up. And Lord, we lift up our nation right now. All of our leaders, Father, whether they are Christians or not, we lift them up and we pray, God, that they see your hand and they see you. And Lord, let revival happen in Washington, D.C. Father, let there be a falling of the Holy Spirit on our nation's capital. Let men and women drop to their knees and say, God, we need you. We can't run this great nation without you. Father, bring revival in these last days. Touch especially our governor, our great governor, Henry McMaster of the state of South Carolina. God, continue to lead him, guide him, protect him, along with our House of Representatives and our leadership at the State House. God, give them wisdom during these trying times. And Lord, touch our pastors all over this nation. Father God, let them have the spirit of Daniel. Lord, they would rise up. That they would not be afraid, that they would be willing to stand up and say, thus saith the Lord, and not cower down and bow down, Father, but they would stand up and say, Jesus is the only way. Father, pull us together in these last days like never before. Let the church be one. Let your people be one in Jesus' name. And all of God's children said, Maranatha, Jesus is coming soon. Love you. See you Sunday.